Students, good morning. Next unit 4, motion lesson. We have some pending topic, that is motion of freely falling body. What we have discussed already, that is equation of motion. In equation of motion, we have discussed, that is three main equation, that is v is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, v square is equal to u square plus 2as. If we want to find out equation for freely falling body, we have to substitute u is equal to 0, initial velocity is 0, then a is equal to g, because acceleration due to gravity, no, for so a is equal to g for first equation. V is equal to u is 0, then a is g, then the equation is turned into v is equal to gt. Then second equation, s is equal to ut plus half at square, ut will be 0, then plus half gt square, so that a is g, s is equal to half gt square we get. Then v square is equal to u square plus 2as. Here u square will be 0, then a is g, so v square is equal to 2gh third equation. Then upwards, a is equal to minus g, that means if the object is thrown vertically upwards, that is opposition to the acceleration due to gravity, so a e will be taken as minus g. If it is downwards, a is equal to plus g. If we want equation like that, we have to substitute a is equal to minus g and a is equal to plus g. Next, uniform circular motion. What is circular motion? Object moving in a circular path, is it not? An object moving with constant speed along a circular path, that is constant speed in a circular path, that is uniform circular motion. If we want to find out speed, we can use the formula speed is equal to circumference by time taken. So that circumference, what is the formula for circumference of the circle? That is 2 pi r, is it not? Then speed or velocity will be taken as v in here. Then time taken is taken as capital T. If we know the value of r and the value of capital T, we can find out the velocity of the object.
First, look at this activity. Students, tie a small piece of stone with a string about 1 meter long. Hold the string tightly in your hand and rotate it. What do you feel? Do you have to apply the force? Does the stone try to pull your hand away? Your hand should exert a continuous force on the stone to maintain the rotation of the stone in the same circle. This force, which is exerted by the hand on pulling stone towards the center, is centripetal force. Hence, when a body moves in a circular path, the force which acts towards the center is called centripetal force. You will also observe that the stone is exerting a force which tries to pull itself away from the center of the circle, that is, away from your hand. This force is the centrifugal force. Similarly, when a body moves in a circular path, the force that acts away from the center is called centrifugal force. While cycling in a bend or a curved path, a cyclist experiences a centripetal force, due to which the cyclist bends inwards. When a bus is moving in the bends, the passengers experience centrifugal force. Due to this force, the passengers bend away from the center of a turn or curve. Students, have you seen a magnet? A magnet exerts force to attract metals like iron, cobalt, and nickel. This pulling, which is exerted by the magnet on the iron, cobalt, or nickel, is called magnetic force.
Next topic, centripetal acceleration. So, what is centripetal acceleration? You just consider, a body is said to be accelerated if the velocity of the body changes either in magnitude or in direction. So, the motion of a stone in a circular path with constant speed and continuous change of direction is an accelerated motion. That is nothing but uniform circular motion, is it not? That is accelerated motion. In this case, there must be an acceleration, the acceleration acting towards the center. This is nothing but centripetal acceleration. In uniform circular motion, the acceleration is acting towards the center. This is nothing but a centripetal acceleration. So, in the circular motion, you can see the velocity vector get continuously changing. Is it not? So, the formula for the centripetal acceleration is centripetal acceleration is equal to v squared by r. R is nothing but radius. V is nothing but this change in velocity. You have detailed derivation in your higher classes for this equation. So, the force which is acting towards the center is nothing but centripetal force. So, the magnitude of centripetal force is F is equal to mass into centripetal acceleration. So, centripetal force is F is equal to mass into centripetal acceleration. So, what is the value of mass? M. What is the value of centripetal acceleration? That is, centripetal acceleration is V squared by R. So, we can substitute here like that. So, F is equal to M into V squared by R. So, the final value is F is equal to MV squared by R. Next topic, centrifugal force. Centrifugal force is nothing but is the force acting on a body away from the center of the circular path. It is said to be centrifugal force. For example, merry-go-round. If you are playing in a merry-go-round, while it is rotating, you can experience the force which is away from the center. This is nothing but example for centrifugal force. And in your book, you can see the activity. In that activity, you have to take a piece of rope and tie a small stone at one end. Hold the other end of the rope and rotate it such that the stone follows a circular path. Do you experience any pull or push in your hand? They asked. If you are rotating like that, you can experience the pulling force, that is outward force. This is nothing but centrifugal force.